Hello.
Hi.
Hey, Glenn.
Hey.
What's happening?
I haven't heard from you in a while.
I said
I haven't heard from you. But
oh.
Sound tired. What are you out of breath for?
Yeah, I just finished the rounds and I'm laid down on my bed.
You sound really low.
Hey?
You sound really low. The phone?
The sound is low?
Yeah.
Well, it's right in front of me. Is that better?
Yeah, a little better.
So yeah, Glenn, I just spoke to one of my family members came down from Canada. And they told me that it takes them longer to get to Manitoba than it did to get to New York.
Yeah.
I was like, wow.
A lot of water up here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A lot of water coming to the Montana region as well, eh? Idaho, Montana.
Yeah, Missouri.
Wyoming. The high Rockies, I guess, that have never melted before, are going to be shedding ice over June and July. So that spring season will run into, but up with summer.
Mm-hmm.
There are people who are out of their homes now for a month and a half.
Yeah.
May end up having to stay out for 3 months.
Yeah, that's going to really tamper with the food supply because all the farmers, they can't even plant yet. So.
Yeah, I hear the weather's really, like, bad. I'm hearing about tornadoes and stuff. And, I think...
can't say we didn't warn people.
Yeah, this is the mayhem they were talking about. And you know what I think, too? I think since I remember I seen an ad with the insurance, I think it was Geico. I'm not sure which... No, it was Allstate. I think it could probably be some type of scam, too. I mean, they probably could profit from this.
Insurance companies always do.
Yeah.
Insurance companies belong to God.
Yeah, they do.
When they don't want to pay, they say that it's
act of
God's
God.
Work.
Yep, act of God, right?
An act of God and Mother Nature.
Yep. Yeah, or if they don't want to pay, they say we don't cover a flood flood accident or something like that.
We all got a letter here this spring from the insurance company saying no flood insurance. Nothing covers water going in your basement. We're 330 feet above sea level, and yet they knew there'd be floods. The only way that can happen is from the sky.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you know of any, like, because I've heard a lot about, on the net, they say, they have technology to control the weather, but a lot of what people on the media says on the internet is that they call it HAARP. But, I don't know about the HAARP, because I hear so many people talk about it. I don't know. Like, I really think that the more people I see talk about it, the less I think it's true. Like, yes, I believe that there is a type of technology that they have, but is it really called HAARP?
HAARP is a code word, I believe, for the type of instrument or keyboard,
yeah,
like organ, that they can play and have people who've set charges in different places around the world that launch volcanoes. You got to remember, weather is dependent upon two things, cold and hot.
Yeah.
We know that cold can be activated by a network of submarines who would drag large blocks of ice from Antarctica into position at the Tropic of Capricorn. And that changes the heat in the water, the position of the heat in the water that basically expands from the equator south. But when you bring up a big block of ice, you're pushing the water deeper and deeper in front of the ice, the hot water. And when it reaches the critical point, it then becomes a shock of energy that rises into the high atmosphere, comes down at the Tropic of Cancer, the Atlantic Ocean, at least as a hurricane. And a hurricane travels feeding off of the hot water and is constantly looking for hotter water.
Yeah.
Since most of the volcanoes are under the sea, you can't see them. What they do is they heat up water along the path of the volcano, and it drags it sideways over to pick up the heat. So, can you manage weather if you live underground and have a network that allows you to bring acetone to different spots that create volcanoes? You can manage heat. If you have a fleet of submarines, like the entire Russian submarine fleet, which is no longer used for military purposes, you can manage cold. Therefore, by positioning things in the Indian Ocean and in places leading up from the Indian Ocean, sure, you can manage weather. Whether or not they are able to be as precise as they appear to be is another question. But there certainly is circumstantial evidence that they can make a tornado drop on any building they choose.
Yeah. That's what happened this week.
Yeah.
It was like they set records this week in weather in the U.S. anyway. So.
Yeah.
Most hurricane, tornado deaths and most tornadoes, everything this week. So.
That's interesting. Like, so you've seen, like, I guess over the years, I'm observing all this stuff, you've seen, like, circumstantial evidence that would point
to the type points to the possibility, if not probability. I would move it to the probability range since 2008.
Yeah.
Well, the key word in weather seems to have been ton, as in Washington. Ton is 2,000 pounds. 2,000 pounds is 2,000 years. 2,000 years is the second century. Never do it on the first decade. You do it on the second decade and the second year of the second decade.
Mm-hmm.
2010, 2011, what we're talking about.
Yeah, I've noticed you've been, that's been like a focal point. You've been focusing on that word a ton. How long have you been looking at that word?
Well, ever since we concluded that Flushing, New York was a toilet. And you had to find the wall that Pink Floyd sang about, Roger Waters. The wall had to be a toilet.
Covers.
That's Lake Superior.
Yeah.
That's the tank. Lake Michigan, Huron, Erie as the actual bowl. Lake Ontario as the septic tank. And New York, Ohio, Illinois, Indiana as the septic field. And that's what we're getting right now. The province of Quebec on the south shore of the St. Lawrence is getting it near Lake Champlain in New York, the Richelieu River, now going on 2 months, they've been flooded. Manitoba, 51% underwater. It's all kind of waiting, the waiting game, which very well could be linked to the melting of the tops of the Rockies. What would normally be a spring thaw that would be over by now, this weather has extended it to the edge of summer, but a spring, a summer thaw of the high Rockies would bring in Canada water through the North and South Saskatchewan rivers, probably ending up at Lake Diefenbaker in the reservoir in Saskatchewan. And then that could crash the dam. It's kind of an earthen dam, but 30 feet high or something.
What is Lake Diefenbaker? What does that word convert to?
Diefenbaker is the name of a German family that migrated there. And a former Prime Minister of Canada was John Diefenbaker, the toilet Diefenbaker. Beef, D-I-E, die.
Mm-hmm.
Beef and fin, fin. Fins are the Caucasian second generation. Baker, Baker, Baker makes something that rises. Know that the Canadian Shield will rise. There's links in the word. If it breaks the dam, it's right at the place called Butte, Saskatchewan. It's a compound word. I forget the whole word, but something that ends in Butte. And it will flow right below the Franciscans. There's a home that they operate in Saskatchewan. Franciscans, and it leads into the Qu'Appelle River Valley, which, when I saw it, was dry. Should it flow, well, it's going to basically go the same route as all the water has gone east out of Saskatchewan towards Brandon, Manitoba, Souris, get into the Red River. Trying to see if there's a name for Butte on this map. It doesn't go that small, I think.
Butte. I know of Butte, Montana.
Yeah. Central Butte is the word.
Central Butte.
Oh, yeah. By the way, with Ogdensburg, I know there's another place in the U.S. I think Dana knows it. It's called Ogden's. And
I think it's
for like an IRS
agency. Yeah.
You think that would be linked to Ogdensburg somehow? That other.
Well,
there's other Ogdensburg too.
Ogden is what Ogden means.
Yeah.
And dealing here with a berg.
It's like a mountain, right?
Yurt means a movable house.
Portable.
Portable house. And human beings are considered portable houses, but if you're on the tip of the Canadian Shield, I guess that fits.
Yeah, it makes sense. It's a port, and it's linked to Able.
Mm-hmm.
This used to be a pirate hideout.
Oh, really?
Sure. It's in Ogden, Utah. That's where that IRS
is.
Yeah. And there are some Ogdens in Great Britain as well.
Oh, really? But he has a couple hideouts.
Yeah. The area in Manitoba, Saskatchewan, where this water is causing a problem,
mm-hmm.
flows south. And eventually, it's got to be in the Missouri River.
Oh, really?
Which Missouri. Eventually takes it to the Mississippi. So all of this melting in Montana as well, from the Rockies, will end up in that same system.
Yeah. So it's like all connected.
Yeah. So you can be sure that what we have now, added to the melting that will carry it over the summer, would prepare it for the breaking of the dam by the fall. Rather than just the 11th day of the 11th month at the 11th hour, we may be dealing with a system that began in May and goes to November.
Yeah, that's what I said. This, like, the mayhem thing you talked about,
yeah.
It makes perfect sense. Like, this is, like, there, because, like, on the news, they're saying, me and Dana were discussing, on the news, they keep saying, this is the worst of this time, this is the worst it's ever been. For every event, from the flood in Manitoba, to the tornado, to the flood in Mississippi, it's all the worst. Like, that's what the media is like. That's the vibe.
Yeah. Record-setting everything.
Yeah. The worst. So I can imagine. I don't know what June is. I think you know what June. Each
Round
month
June, you're getting a lot of important days in June because they're linked to the Holy Ghost.
Mm.
coming of the Pentecost. So, and with Sunday, with Monday.
Oh, yeah, and you were talking about Passion Week, and that was like, I guess that's what the whole tornado and everything was.
Yeah.
And June, that word June is,
One.
I think it's linked to the word junior.
Well, it's
I-O-R.
The U then.
Then.
Because the J can be a D if you put two of them together.
That's linked to like Odin or Uden. Odin.
Yeah. And to the nuns, are in the middle, one, nun.
Did you find anything more? By the way, did you find anything else with those nuns in South America? They were like linked to the Baptist or something like that, Bath Party.
Well, not specifically.
Yeah, it's kind of not in your area, really, not really.
Well, I lose kind of the ability to know where to look. I leave the North American region. Well, some things are easy enough to guess. You know, Mediterranean is going to be an important waterway. Caspian Sea, yeah, an important waterway over in Asia. You got to remember what Jenny was saying is the message is water is the mode of transmission. That doesn't limit it to what the water does per se. It also includes what the water brings on. Radon is a product that normally comes out of the ground, a gas that causes lung cancer because of water. It can appear in people's taps. We have people around here who go around doing testing of your water for radon. When you open up the tap, you're getting a cancer-causing gas in your kitchen.
Yeah, so it could, like, evaporate into the air.
Yeah.
Wow, damn, you don't even have to drink it.
And then you have all the trash that it creates and is dragging all over the place, and people can get hit by stuff floating on the water. And the germs that are created from the flushing out of sewers and toilets and stuff. So you can't limit the entire problem to the actual water directly, but what it causes.
Yeah.
You know, anybody doubted that we were in a time equivalent to the 10 plagues in Egypt, for example.
You what?
You only need to look around.
And the water also
loosened
things up, too.
I didn't hear that.
I think they know.
So the water also loosens everything up, too. So movements of the ground.
Foundation.
Yeah. Sinkholes and all types of stuff, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, I found another Emerson. I forgot his first name, but he wrote a book called The Smoky God.
Mm-hmm.
And it's related. I guess it's in the genre of, like, Edith Torpor.
Well, the story of the 10 plagues was the allegory of let my people go. And in this case, it's the story of Let Jenny Come Home. Until they do something on that side, I'm afraid they're going to get one after the other.
So you're saying it's all on them? Like, it's nothing that could be done on Jenny's side? Like, there's nothing, like she's tried everything. There's no type of maybe, paperwork she can
do? Well, right now she is completing a project of informing the people on that side, within the hospital community, within the political community, and within the religious community. They are all basically receiving letters. And hang on a second. I'll read a part of this letter, which is addressed to some of the hospitals, and copies are sent to the politicians. There is, however, another possibility that could have to do with me being passed over for a position in this state facility, which is why I have chosen to begin this letter the way I have. Investigators working with the Canadian Institute for Political Integrity have been investigating my situation here in Ogdensburg, as well as my past, and have theorized, based on the data at this point, that I am being locked out of a job situation based upon who I am and what I represent to the power structure. Therefore, we'll now list what is known at this point to me, as well as investigators who have been investigating my situation on behalf of the Canadian Institute for Political Integrity. So we are all concluding the same things. I was genetically planned, brought into this life, assigned to the Nagel family by Wilder Penfield, a much applauded and respected neurosurgeon based in Montreal at McGill University, who was known, along with his associate, Ewan Cameron, to be involved in research on the brain for the purpose of mind control, known in the U.S. as MKUltra, using persons, including children, as subjects without their knowledge or consent. Parents' family have apparently benefited from my involvement in this research, as I have recently been informed that my parents had established a trust fund for payment of what was being done to me. Currently, I'm told by investigators that there are millions of dollars in that fund. My life was to be a study, an experiment in Wilder Penfield's memory research on the brain. The condition of multiple personalities was purposely induced in me through repeated ritualistic trauma that included sexual abuse perpetrated on me by my father and carried out through the ensuing years into my adulthood by others who were of a military background, as well as being overseen by the Benedictine monks up Angel, Oregon. The purpose was to cover up the symptoms this research induced in me with the repeated programming techniques employed against my person. I was never asked if I wanted to be part of this. Consider what has been done to me to be criminal acts. In spite of the many abuses and crimes perpetrated against me, I continued to attempt to have a life of my own, never realizing the full extent of my involvement and the victimization until recently. I began to be aware that something was very wrong in 1989. This is when my harassment began because I had sought help for myself and for my children, who were showing signs and symptoms of having been involved in ritualistic abuse, per the observations of psychiatrists and therapists, who were also not allowed to testify in family court on their behalf. For attempting to assist my children, physical and legal custody were taken away, and I was made to leave my home so that my then husband had the freedom to move his girlfriend in to act as their quote-unquote mother. Placed on federal disability at my request in 1991 because the consequences of harassment induced included severe post-traumatic stress disorder and depression. Used the ensuing years to recover memories and deal with resulting and constant harassment. I decided in 1999 that I wanted and needed to go back to work because I had done as much work as could be done to recover memories and to come to terms with what had been done to me. Fortunately, in 1998, the last time I was kidnapped and worked over, i.e., given huge amounts of electric shock by unknown perpetrators, brackets which resulted in a hospitalization, did not realize that I was being, quote-unquote, prepared, i.e., programmed, for an interview with David Icke in order to perpetrate the system's media lie and program. That interview took place within 5 months of the last episode. Individuals magically appeared in my life to connect me to David Icke. I was being prepared for this role by as early as 1996, and was programmed to change my name legally to Arizona Wilder, Wilder being Penfield's first name, and Arizona having to do with the follow-up and continuing research of Wilder Penfield's work on me by Arizona State University in Tucson. When I was hired at Clearview, I had no idea that I would one day be the director of nursing. In 2006, I changed my name legally back to Jennifer Nagel. I still did not understand why I had been made to change my name to Arizona Wilder and why I had done this interview. So I never laid any of this to rest, but continued to research. Recently become aware that my prior naive conclusions that secret groups, organizations within the system, and operating subversively, covertly, are responsible for these abuses, criminal acts that nobody knows about, is in error. The truth is the system knows all about it and is kept informed about persons that have been the subject of the attention from these groups. In fact, there is no secret in the system about these groups. They are known entities operating and funding within the system. In short, everybody knows. And I think that refers to human resources people, personnel departments, that kind of stuff in different organizations, such as, you know, in a hospital, the nurses interview the person for her qualifications, but then they have to get approval from a human resources person in the hospital. And I think these are the people, and I've met a number of these people, including one that was the personnel human resource person in charge at the Royal Canadian Mounted Police. Mother lived just down the street from me here. She was there for 34 years. These people, including the clerks, the receptionists that are in place for long, long periods of time, usually have a list of all of the people who are being tracked so that when one of them shows up for employment, they know who they're dealing with.
So she sent this letter out to people who you just
right
said
now,
that they know.
Right now, it's at the Vatican.
She sent it to the Vatican.
It's at the papal representative in the U.S. Mm. It's at the governor's office. It's at the Attorney General's office. It's at the hospitals, at the people who, in fact, participated. All of the different hospitals that prevented Jenny from getting employment and gave no reason, or invented phony examinations to keep her from being considered. You know, one hospital wanted her to take a chemistry exam, basically the work of a pharmacist, and it's not the work of a psychiatric nurse. There are other people who specialize in that kind of stuff, but it was basically given to her to stop her from getting employment. Phones here. You there?
Yeah, I'm still here.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah, so for one reason or another, U.S. has been working in concert with the border guards, run by a guy by the name of Vic Tays, I told you about before, who seems to be the right-hand man of the Prime Minister, linked to Mennonites and Hutterites and Quakers and Amish and that crowd from Manitoba. He's an immigrant to Canada, I understand, from Uruguay. Hayes suggests the name is German. Family would have migrated to South America sometime around the end of the war. Don't know the details, but he seems to be the real Prime Minister of Canada. Prime Minister just plays the harp. Stephen Harper, cosmetic Prime Minister of Canada, while this guy, real guy behind the scene, he wrote, of course, Jenny a letter saying that her exclusion order could not be rescinded, and in the letter mentioned a number of things that were factually false. We believe at the Institute that he may not even have seen the file.
Oh, I want to ask a question. That order, exclusion order, does it say anywhere on it that it's non-negotiable?
No, it says...
So then it's a negotiable instrument, and you could probably negotiate.
It basically is a document that says this order can only be reversed by the Minister of Citizenship and Immigration. And yet when we wrote to Citizenship and Immigration, because it says so on the order, they claim they have nothing to do with it, that it is public safety. I said, that's a lie. I'm reading the order.
So did they say that after you faxed them a copy and they seen it themselves?
No, they didn't want to know anything. They basically, it was political flunkies that you get to speak to. You don't get to speak to the minister or anybody.
Right. You can't go there personally?
Probably the people who actually did the work. These, you know, fat bottom ladies who make the rocking world go around are not all fat bottom.
So, Glenn, you can't go there, like, personally?
If you went and tried to see the minister personally, you'd get arrested.
Oh, what? Really?
Security guards.
I mean, you're not going there with mal intent, not to hurt anybody.
That doesn't matter to them.
These are public officials, right? Like, you can't... Wow. But Glenn, you know what, man?
Close to anybody with supposed power.
Glenn, you know what? I feel like I want to go there myself.
When I was a kid, I used to walk from my place to buildings, walk in the building, up and down the hallways, look inside an office, say hi to people in there. All the members of parliament were there. That was 60 years ago. Now,
times have changed.
They tried to pass a law to keep me from being within 75 meters of any door because I just wanted to ask the prime minister to stop stealing. 20 years after they tried to pass that law, the Prime Minister was found guilty by a committee of the House of Commons of taking bribes and kickbacks. So, you know, you get arrested for telling the truth. I spent 1,000 days on Parliament Hill, 3 years, and I filed charges. And everybody I charged was found worthy of being sent to trial by the Chief Justice of the Peace. Only the politician stepping in delayed the trial, and the Ontario Provincial Police were assigned the task to reinvestigate. And, of course, you can see it today with all that's happening with people, women getting beat up in the courthouses. Police come in, Ontario Provincial Police, and they drive the getaway. They drove the getaway car for the Prime Minister when I filed the charges. They drive the getaway car now for people who get beat up, and they come in and investigators. So it's not the country I believed it was.
So I think I want to do that, just my own little thing. I think when I go up to Canada, Glenn, I think I'm just going to go there on my own and I just want to see things for myself. I would like to go to this citizenship and immigration, this whatever place it is, wherever it is. I don't know if you want to tell me or whatever, because I would to go there and see.
It's in Vanier, the Ottawa East. I know exactly where it is.
I'm going there. I'm gonna go there, Glenn. I hope I don't get arrested though. But go there.
Oh, you'll notice when you get to the ground floor, there's security people there, and you're not allowed to go in the building unless
you're invited.
The building has invited you.
Really?
You have
Does it say that on the outside, on the outside of the building?
Some clearance they want, right?
Yeah, because how can they arrest me if I have no warning? If I could go in the building,
that's,
it's just like
when,
you know?
When they give you the warning, they say, no, you can't go up.
Oh, okay, all right. And I'll ask,
you have no invitation from anybody in the building. You're not allowed up.
So, but I'll ask, you know, like, how can I set up an appointment or whatever? Because I really want to.
To the Ottawa Police Department back in 2006. I think it was after 7/7 in London when there was a bombing.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
And I brought documentation. What I was asking is that the police come here to the farm and search below ground at the farm for the possibility of a weapons cache. I believe that part of that building that's below ground could very well be a storage place. Security guard would not let me see a policeman at the police department. And I was telling them that I believe that my own place below ground is possibly being used for storage of weapons or other things. He asked me to leave the documents with him. And I said, no, I want to give it to a policeman. Wouldn't allow me to see anybody. So I turned around and he yelled at me, get back here. I ignored him and I walked out the door. The next day, I get a phone call from the police saying they would like to meet me in a restaurant.
Oh, yeah, I read about that in your older post.
And I said, I am not meeting anybody in a restaurant in Ottawa. You come here. And when you come here, be prepared that from the time you enter the neighborhood, you're going to be on videotape. You can sit in my living room and you can be assured you're going to be taped. You come and tell me what you need to tell me here. He never came.
Well, at least you did warn him, because if you would have told him that you're not going to be videotaped in your living room, you probably could have gotten in trouble. At least you told him.
I've done everything I can. All they do is arrange, phony accidents for Tom with the vehicle that we had in 2008 so that we would end up paying three times the monthly insurance premium on insurance on the vehicle. We're still paying. The payment is about $250 a month.
Wow.
It used to be about $700 a year.
That's more than I pay, man.
So they steal, they lie, they cheat, they fabricate things, and that's the police.
Yeah. That's what they're good at, man.
And then the politicians run a school based on psychiatric examinations that they can pick and choose the border guards from the ones that are most in need of psychiatric help. Psychotics are running the borders. I mean, what do you?
That's for sure.
You know, we're basically dealing here with. I complained to border superintendents about the fact that somebody's planning a flood. They ignore it, and then I discover that they're the ones responsible for flood control. That's what he does. The guy I spoke to part-time is he runs the flood control for Western Canada. You know? So you're basically pointing the finger at the criminals all the time. In any event, what they haven't figured out or don't want to believe, I don't care which way it goes, mm-hmm. is that their boss, God, is not the top dog. God has a boss who's not too happy with them. Not much different from when the U.S. or Canada were established. The people who funded their journey here and set them up gave them instructions, and those people, instead of following the instructions, did whatever it is they wanted to do, fill their own pockets. Many of them, when they went back to visit the old country, were locked up in prison for having stolen. The first Prime Minister of Canada was impeached for asking Canadian Pacific Railways for, quote-unquote, another $10,000 for his personal pocket back in 1867 or something. I forget the year. So, I mean, when we were kids, we must have been really naive, because I'm sure this hasn't started now, problems that we have. It's just that I know more now. That's why I've told you a number of times, many things that you don't learn until you've passed enough time doing it.
Yeah.
The advantage that I have now is in looking back. I was born a few blocks from Parliament Hill. I know the infrastructure of the place completely, and I know how it was supposed to work and how they claimed it worked and how the media tells everybody it works, and it's all bullshit. The media is worst of all the systems, because they're the people who lie by omission. Religious gang lie by commission. The politicians just gather in the loot and are cosmetic leaders, when in fact they're being directed from behind the scenes. It's no different in any other democratic country. First thing a democracy demands is freedom of religion and freedom of the press. That's like saying, give control of your life to these two groups.
Yeah.
Politicians work for them. Fascism, communism, capitalism, you name them, they're all the same. They're run by a bunch of guys behind the scenes.
Yeah, but, you know, it is bleak, but you still give them, like, a run for their money, because, like, just look at what an individual could do. An individual who knows who he is, knows where he came from, and knows where he's going.
Power of one.
Exactly.
Much more empower, empowered than the power of a group. The minute you form a group with members, the minute you have members, these people can be infiltrators.
Yeah, well, a lot of people have programmed, I see that, to think that's the solution to everything is forming a group, you know.
I tell people we don't have members. We have investigators. Each person that I deal with is responsible for investigating how the system works in his own surroundings or her own surroundings and bring the information to a central place. Have it evaluated by professional investigators. Those professional investigators are people who have investigated for more lives, let alone years, than people can count.
Yes.
Can't hide from creation.
That's interesting. If that's the case, I have a lot of information to give. I would like to get overviewed.
These people are investigating everything we look into. We have a job to do, and that's to report to creation that we have with our own hands, eyes, nose, ears, have tested out all the lies. Have proven them to be such that when a new universe is created, there are modifications that must take place. Next attempt, creating what creation wanted for human beings in the first place, freedom in its real sense. Wisdom in its real sense. Happiness in its real sense. That's what creation offered to this universe, and that's what Creator hijacked and stole and continues to enslave. That's what we have to change as soon as possible. If we can't do it, they're not going to win anyways. Look around the world and see the management changes that are going on, including lately the International Monetary Fund. Including the president of Egypt, the president of Syria, the president of Yemen.
Yeah.
Everything is being changed. If these people think that just because they rigged the last election in Canada and Stephen Harper has been given a mandate for 5 years, don't take for granted that means they can last 5 years. This may be the last election ever. There may be a change in the geography of North America that changes everything around. So, as there is change going on the political side all around Europe and Asia and Africa, one or the other will happen. Either these people will smarten up. That requires they be touched by a new way of thinking. If they don't, world will be different. You guys are the basement meeting done in public on the net and on the telephone.
It's the it's basement meeting. It's the public, it's the private public type of meeting. It's like a public people know about, but people don't.
In the old days, they used to hide in the basement a few people and say, "What do we do about
this?" Yeah.
And start a revolution. Well, revolutions are useless. They play into the hands of the people with the guns. What we're talking about is evolution. Kick out the evolutionists. Let us get back on track. Proceed with.
So you're saying we're like the body response. Immune system inside of
our
body.
Yeah. Got it.
Yeah.
We are the immunizers.
Sanitizers.
What do they call them? The white blood cells? The white cells.
Well, I wouldn't call you white blood cells. That would be an insult.
Yes.
In any event, you got to remember that Encyclopedia Britannica graph of the universe in which they compare what they call dark matter, dark energy. What the word dark is linked to the word arc. Before genetic engineering and since genetic engineering. And before genetic engineering, 63% of the people on the planet were free. After genetic engineering, linked to the day of Noah's Ark, 72% of the people of the planet are slaves. This was done in 2010. 72%. Say 23%. Where is that 23%, I ask? Got to be in some jungles someplace.
Yeah, well, I was just recently I was looking at there's a group of people in the Amazon. In the languaging, they never learned. It was like they were left out of this updating, I guess, with language. But in their language, they don't even know how to count.
By the way, someone in the chat box is basically asking a question. If you could answer, Glenn, of any upcoming dates of disaster, I guess. Some people who aren't on the call, but they're in the chat box function.
Impossible to do because that person is being guided by events and the development of events. therefore, the person who requires an answer should be told a window of opportunity is what the system works on. Each disaster in their mind has to occur within a time frame, not a day, not a minute, not an hour, a time frame. That time frame is normally 8 years, give or take 2 years either side. The time frame that we're in now began in 2008, will end 8 years later, 2016. Give or take 2 years, it meant at the beginning, it could have started in 2006, and could end in 2018. That's as close to an educated guess as I can get. My belief is that there are three events linked to approximately 20-year periods. We're dealing now with event number one. Event number two should end sometime around 2038, and the final event 2058. Within the context of that 20 years is that 8-year window of opportunity.
Yes.
And there should be a cleanup factor at about 2062. That's simply educated guess based on Windows. That's the reason Microsoft preaches Windows.
But there was a certain year in Microsoft where Windows is like really, that year it was, I think it was like 97. Like, a matter of fact, there's like still old programs that people use Windows.
If anybody else wants to guess, be my guest. I'm only guessing based upon my background and my clues, information that has passed through my hands. Doesn't make it right, perfect, or sure. It just means anybody's taken the time to look into this, they have as much a right as I have to guess.
Well, actually, I was talking to some people, and they were saying that they noticed some comets that they saw. Do you know anything about that?
From who?
Some comets that were, that, I don't know, they say that they found. And he was mentioning that he...
How do you spell that word?
Comets?
Yeah.
C-O-M-E-T?
Comets.
Yeah.
C-O-M-E-T.
Yeah.
Well, you got 10 in there. and you got 2.
Yeah.
So I don't know.
Oh, yeah, by the way, when you were mentioning the word dark, as in dark energy, dark matter.
You start with the second letter, yeah.
But dark, if you switch the letters, it's card, and I know, like, you know, card games and stuff like that. Like, they love, that's like one of the games they made, and I don't know. It seems to be like a game that's supposedly chance. Hello, oh, somebody's. Hello.
Yeah.
Somebody just said something.
Yeah.
Hear that? I think somebody
missed. I don't hear anything.
Oh, I thought I heard something.
Yeah, well, that's the best that I can do. Any other questions?
Nope.
Okay, I'm going to go off and do my catch-up, feed the hay to the animals.
Okay. All right, Glenn.
Have a good week.
Mm-hmm.
Wish you all the best of luck. You're all welcome to call again.
Okay.
Bye for now.
Okay, bye.